Quad trilogies. Whether it be the Avengers, Toy Story, or Despicable Me. Jesus Christ, did Despicable Me even need four movies? You'd think one would be enough, but money's money, I guess. But there's one Quad trilogy so good that I doubt anyone even remembers it. But first, let's go back a decade. LMFAO's Music Quadrilogy is truly a piece of art.
It gave me a rock hard cock.
It starts off with the music video, Sexy and I Know It, and that starts with it, Red Fu, on a beach with his friends. I'm just gonna call him Red for the duration of this video. And his friends, none of them are really that important
Around.
except the Daft Punk reject because, believe it or not, he gets laid at the end. And while on the beach, they just start going on the street and start dancing out of nowhere. Then they all have the genius idea to start shaking their bulges in front of everybody. And obviously, this catches the attention of basically everybody at the beach. But most importantly, the most stereotypical white biker gang you could ever imagine. So, after this, Red has a very intense training session.
Let's go, champ!
And after his training session, him, some what I would like to presume are escorts, and his friends walk into a club. But the same bikers from before follow him. But before Red could go and swing his own dick again, the leader of the biker gang pushes him off the counter and proceeds to wiggle his dick in front of the whole entire bar. Then, Red, obviously offended by this action.
How can you do this? This is outrageous. It's unfair. How can
you be at a bar but not wiggle your dick?
Starts a gang war
Death to the FBLA!
of sorts between these two factions. And yeah, they just start wiggling their dick around. They start using a table as a catwalk, and before you know it, the whole entire bar is in on the fun, and they're all doing their little quirky stunts, right? And it finally ends off with the Mr. Daft Punk reject getting the same girls Red got like 10 minutes prior. So, next up in the saga is Sorry for Party Rocking, which starts off at an old couple arguing with some great humor, of course.
My Rufus,
biggest.
Look at me!
Hell no, I don't wanna die!
About Red's party, it isn't stated exactly when this takes place on the Shuffleclips timeline, but I'm pretty sure it takes place right after Sexy and I Know It. So, the old man, Rufus, tells Red and his friends to
Shut
shut the
the fuck
fuck up,
up!
but in return, Red magically summons a brand new song called
Sorry for Party
Rufus
Rockin'.
gets pissed and proceeds to call the cops, the ambulance, FedEx, and some pizza place for some reason. So, when the police get there, they actually pretend to arrest Red, but they're there to party rock with Red and the criminal they have. Also, everybody else shows up. The other member of the duo, Sky Blue, who I'm just gonna call Blue, gets introduced. Red is having an amazing time with everybody, including Rufus's wife. Apparently, they were
They're
raping
raping
zebras
zebras!
outside. But sadly, Red and Blue get put into a coma by excessive party rocking. Which makes zero sense because Blue was just in a car the whole entire time. But while being rolled out the Shufflebot door, yeah, that's the robot's name, Shufflebot, how creative. So, while being rolled out, he drops his BlackBerry, which just so happens to contain the worldwide hit, Party Rock Anthem. So, while Red is being sent to the ER, this man, pretty sure doesn't have a name, continues party rocking to Party Rock Anthem. Also, everybody else at the party just continues to keep on party rocking. Like the host didn't just get put into a coma. And so, Sorry for Party Rocking ends with a shot of Red and Blue in a hospital where, because of some magical shocks of electricity, Blue wakes up.
The date is March 29th. The shuffling disease has taken the world by storm. Everybody that you used to know and love, including the Shufflebot, are now just living their lives on the streets as a bunch of lifeless, shuffling zombies. Only the strongest willed ones could resist the shuffling apocalypse.
So, Party Rock Anthem starts off with Red and Blue pulling a Kanye.
Bitch, I'm back out my coma.
So, when they wake up, they decide to leave only to see a wasteland that Todd Howard could only dream of achieving.
16 times the detail.
Then they also see the same person which found Red's phone. Then they quickly get scolded by a man who probably used too much Reddit and probably got pissed off at the funny wholesome man got turned into a brain dead zombie or something. So then u/wholesome chungus69 tries to give them some beats, but Red and Blue tell him,
get the fuck out of here!
Right after everyone starts dancing together. At first, Red and Blue are intrigued by the shufflers because they wrote such meaningful lyrics such as party rockers in the house tonight, but they don't become fully committed to the shuffle life until hearing a beat drop so good that it can make any Skrillex fan submit. So for the rest of the video, nothing really that important happens. It's just everybody dancing together in harmony because it's not about the story. It's about sending a message. Also, I forgot to mention this, but Jesus shows up for some reason. Also, Shufflebot's back, so that's great. So, on to Champagne Showers. So, now it's been 1 week since Red and Blue became zombies, and shufflers are now having raves, which is exactly what Red and Blue have been trying to look for. So, Champagne Showers starts off in the middle of downtown Transylvania, and in the search of the ultimate shuffling party, some guy, once again, pulls them over, and after recognizing them as the Shuffle Guys, he says he knows a party that would change their lives. So then they go to some underground hidden bunker party, which just so happens to be ran by sexy vampires. Also, this is probably my favorite song out of the saga, but as you all know, my music critique days are long gone. So Red and Blue go right back to shuffling with the zombies, and hey, what do you know, Shufflebot's back. Yay. So then the vampires end up seducing them, but they go right back to dancing because hell, who needs them? And also, for some reason, they magically got these new force powers. But right before anybody knows it, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, just magically reappears. But this time, he has some of that holy champagne. And it just so happens to be that that holy champagne is the cure to the vampire disease. So, Red, Blue, Shufflebot, and some random guy all go on this massive purifying spree on the vampires with these holy bottles. Now, we finally did it. With all the vampires gone, all that's left to do now is party! And that's exactly how the story ends. And just like every other video, this one has a very cool dance circle. And with Jesus. So, that's how this masterpiece of the quadrilogy ends. And hey, if you guys enjoyed, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.